Well, that's where we're at right now. That's our new cylinder head in that big black box. This is our timing chain kit for the front and rear chains. Let's see, these are our head bolts. There's our head gasket. And the mess that's going to end up going into the scrapyard. So we're as torn down as we're going to get, with the exception of pulling the cylinder head off. So we're going to get all of this right here reassembled first, and then we can get it put back up onto the engine stand, get that all closed up, put it back on the engine stand, pull the head off of it, and then we can take the new head that's sitting in that black box and put it on this engine. Take our timing chain kit here and go through what we've got in here. So right now we're interested in just the stuff for the back. Chain guide for the rear. Tensioner for the rear. Chain for the rear, and I think that's all of what we got right now for the rear. So let's start getting this chain soaked in the oil. We're going to start assembling the timing chain and components on the rear end of this block. Take our guide, bolt the guide in place first. There's going to be three of these little bolts. It's going to be sitting right about there. So we're going to put one bolt in right here. And then here. Plus, we also need to put one in right here. And one in right there. Spin those all the way in. Almost accident, almost all the way. Go in cautiously. That one doesn't need anything to check on. Alright, now let's get these marks lined up. That one's supposed to be right at 12 o'clock. This one right here is at 12 o'clock. I think this one's supposed to be at 11:30, and this one is supposed to be at about 2:30. So there's 2, there's 3 o'clock, so 2:30 is right there, roughly. We do have colored links on the chain to line those up with. So let's grab that chain. Basically, just take this and hang it for now. Okay, just like so. All in place right there. Cool. So we got that link and this link lined up. now that I've got the chain on, let's get the tensioner. Got a couple of different pins in here to be cautious about. And these require the long bolts. They're gonna go in right there and there. You know, run those right down in. Okay, what I like to do is get everything snug and then backed off just a hair so that everything's got just a little bit of movement in it. Now we can get everything tightened down properly. Probably actually shouldn't have done that just yet. Let's back these back off. Stay here, because I want to take the slack out of this chain and then get this where it needs to be. Double check on the link, link on the dot, link on the dot, link on the dot, we're good to go. Pull safety out and pull the pin. If the pin will come out. Come on, pin, you can come out. There we go. Now let's get this tension. Where the chain's not going to be slapping around. It's all loose enough. Slack on that side. Right. Double check. And we'll come back. Double check these with a torque wrench. And then we can put our new seal into the cover, put the cover on. Now we're going to try to attempt to get the old seal out of the cover. Which, if you guys can see this, this old seal is in pretty rough shape. It doesn't even spring itself back. It needs to go. You take a chisel, get three little indents in here. You're gonna try tapping in. Out comes the old seal, which is kind of stiff. Take the new seal, put the new seal in, make sure everything here is nice and clean. does have a step that it bottoms out on. So keep that all nice and clean as well. Seal, which is where? Right here. We got an installing tool for it as well. I believe this is for sliding over the crankshaft once this is in place. Now that's the inside, so this goes in this way. Seal. Don't have a very good shape left out. Pull this piece out for now. Okay. I'm going to give you a silly little lip on the inside. Use this one to drive that one so we don't damage anything. Sounds pretty solid all the way around. It's evenly seated all the way around. So we're ready to put a little bit of oil on this to put it back on, but we gotta treat all of this with silicone first. All except for across the middle of the bottom here. And we gotta make sure that all of the surface here that this is going to be sealing up against is clean. Alright. Brake cleaner, paper towels. Brake cleaner. Another perimeter. And another paper towel as well. Just gonna wipe all around the perimeter. Just gonna make sure that our RTV is not going to leak at all. It can't have any oil on it. Same thing on that cover. Alright, now that I've done the sloppy job of getting all of the RTV everywhere, we gotta make sure we got oil on the seal, slide the cover on, and hopefully I'm still recording. Alright, now cover is already sealed all the way around. We're going to put just a little bit of oil on this seal right here. So it slides in and out of there nice and easily. And we're going to line this up. rotator pins in here, so be mindful of those as well. Now let's get all of the perimeter bolts in place. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And I have to clean all of the oil off of these as well. There. Now the oil has been removed from the bolts. And I don't think this RTV is going to live much longer. Bolts are in about one turnout. You don't want to take a chance of over torquing them, even though the little wimpy gun might not do it. We're going to snug these up by hand, and then we're going to come back after the RTV has had a chance to set, and we'll come back and revisit torquing these down. I'm just putting these in super, super light. Right now, each one of these is probably about 3 or 4 foot-pounds of torque. And we're just going to let this sit. And we're going to let it cure. Then we're going to come back and torque these all down. And get it situated again on the engine stand. Start taking the head off. Thank you. pick up the tools and get out of here. Stop tipping on me. There we go. And what did we get? We got all the tips, all the seals. The caps didn't pop off, almost. But yeah, we'll need to clean and soak these. They're looking a little bit kind of rough. Let's see, sensors. It's the bolt for that one. Oh, good grief. One solenoid, two sensors. Stuck in there. There we go. Stubborn. Stubborn. And it's also just a tad bit on the clogged up side. Yeah, definitely a little on the clogged up side. Yep. probably not the rear. Maybe it is the rear. And the little...
Good job.
See what happens if we lift up on it. Ready for this? Right. Wants to come up with the gasket on this side. Set that back down. We're going to tip this forward a little bit for the dramatic reveal. Hopefully it doesn't fall off in the process. Hey, we have a dramatic pour. Okay. And the dramatic reveal.